here now. Somebody better get a shout on, because you don't know what tomorrow is going to hold. Somebody praise him. Glory.
I gotta serve
need your help. Doctor can't help me. The lawyer can't help me.
Start with Romans 12:1-2. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. There's a void, and I need to be transformed. Today's message is dedicated to those who are seeking some good news, those who have been bound, the brokenhearted, those who need to be comforted, those who need joy, and those who need their praises lifted. Because you are a strong person and your soul refused to die, let me lead you to a place where the Lord can wrap his arms around you and fill the void you have in your life. I come to encourage you today that symbolically to the Bible days is Palm Sunday. And Palm Sunday was a time where our Savior came to town. Your Savior is in town. He's here to help you. He was off in other places doing other things for other people, but today he's here to see about you. You've been waiting and wondering, when is he going to get here? When is he going to get you out of this mess? When will your bad days pass? Well, today's the day. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, there's a void, and I need to be transformed. My subject today is be ye transformed. Be ye transformed. Be ye transformed. Let it sink in. Be ye transformed. Not only do we know that our Savior is in town, we also know that one word from the Lord will change our lives. It will cause a transformation to take place. Close your eyes and say, be ye transformed. Say it till you believe it. Tell you, you're talking to yourself. Telling you, you're not talking to your neighbor. You're talking to yourself. Do it again. Close your eyes and say, be ye transformed. Now, people are always saying the Lord is here. He's going to fix it. He's going to work it out for you. But nothing ever seems to work. Nothing ever seems to change. Well, I understand how you feel because I've been there before. But I want you to press your way. Press your way to the King. Get through all that mess and get to the Savior. Consider the woman with the issue of blood. She knew the Savior was in town. Jesus didn't just come and stand right beside her. She had to press her way. No matter what the naysayers say or how people attempt to treat you, stand on your faith. Trust you have a Savior, and your Savior is here for you. Your Savior is here to do what you need him to do, and that is to free you from bondage, oppression, and worry. He's here to deliver you, to set you free, to loose the chains that have been holding you captive. Can we say praise the Lord? Now I read from my paper, but I need y'all to be in this with me. I need y'all to really get this. It's for you. It's for us. I need you to get what I'm saying. Okay? I'm only reading from the paper because I want to make sure that I cover lies, idols, and false gods. It seeks to use you to enlarge the enemy's camp using lies and deceit. I challenge you today not to conform to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Change your thoughts according to the Spirit of God. Release the cares of this world, fame, acceptance, approval, unfaithfulness, selfishness, self-serving actions, and focus on God. Focus on the things above, things that are pure. Learn to be helpers one to the other, not in lust, but in love. Not in self-glory, but in God's glory. Be a witness. Be a light. This is how and when God gets the glory out of your life. Be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Get saved. Reconnect yourself to God. Allow him to save you from this world. Allow him to deliver you from this world. Allow him to free your soul from all the bondage that this world has you tangled up in. Your mind can't be free because of all the mess that's going on around you. Come out from among them and be ye separate, set apart. Now, I'm not talking about your actions. I'm talking about your mind, your thoughts. Because once your mind is cleansed from all the mess that has you bound, you will no longer have a desire for the actions that lead you to bondage. See, it's not our body actions that God judges. It's the heart. It's the intent. It's the mind that forms the action. So if you can free your mind, your body will be free too. Think about the legal system. They judge you based on your intent. The sentence for premeditated crimes is higher than circumstantial crimes. So long as I sin and premeditate and think it through in my mind and then perform the action, I'm going to have a higher sentence than if I just something just happens and I get caught up into something. Okay, so it's all about what goes on in the mind. It's the intent is what causes us problems. Okay, so I come to encourage you that you can live free from that mess. You can move beyond it. You can leave it in the past. You can have power over it. But first, you have to clean your mind. You have to have a pure heart, a heart that allows you, that allows love to flow through it. Uh-oh, roadblock. Now she's talking about that love thing. See, some of us are bound because love isn't flowing through us. It either flows to us or it may even flow from us. But there's a blockage, an obstruction somewhere that prohibits the proper flow of love in our lives. See, we get confused because we give or because someone gives to us and we say we have love. But true love flows and keeps flowing. Example, if I give to you and you receive, and that's as far as it goes, then love is not flowing. It's blocked or hindered. But if I give to you and you receive, then you give to them and they receive, and they give to someone else, and that someone else receives and gives to someone else, Then and only then is love flowing, when it has an entrance and an exit. But if I receive, you got to think about Christmas. You know, we say we give, it's a time of giving, a time of sharing. Okay, so if I give a gift to somebody, they don't have to necessarily give a gift back to me. But if they get a gift, and then they give a gift to someone else, then love is flowing. It's circulating. People are receiving gifts, okay? Receiving the love. Things are flowing. So it has a flow, not just I give and that's the end of it. That doesn't feel like a time of love. Not because you didn't give back to me, but because you're not giving. It's not in your heart to give. So there's no flow of love. This something is out of rhythm. Okay? So, but if I receive and I don't give back, it's not because I want it all to myself. A lot of times we think people are just selfish and just don't want to give. It's not that. It's because I'm so bound, I don't realize I'm stopping the flow in my own life. Then you are allowing God to use you, allowing spending time with God to minister to you. You can't be like that. We can't continue on because we end up running ourselves ragged, okay? Running our health into the ground. And then we end up with all these doctor bills, all because we done ran ourselves ragged. We done put the world first instead of putting God first. But if we put God first, everything else will fall into line. It's an order. It's a proper alignment that God expects for us to follow. He didn't put us here or leave us here on this earth to just be in existence. He put us here with strength. He gave us help. He gave us the Holy Ghost that will even come and lead us to all understanding. He's not just there and not there. We have to reach out and touch him. We have to touch him so he can touch us back. We have to consult him so he can direct us. We have to allow him to be a present help in our time of need. Not just a past help, but a present help in our time of need. We have to allow God to be who he is. He's our creator. We didn't create ourselves. All these problems that we're dealing with are just really destroying our lives. It's bothering us and hindering us from being fruitful. God didn't put us here to be sour-faced and unfruitful, but he expects us to be a glow, a light in the midst of darkness. The world is a dark place. It's a dry place. But he has anointed us to be that light. He has touched us so we can be fruitful and have enough to share to those that are in darkness. Because, see, when we go before the throne, because we have that relationship, we can get an understanding. And we can take our understanding and share with someone else and give them understanding, those that are in darkness. This is how we allow our light to shine. We're not supposed to just get it and just allow it to be consumed within us. But when we have those voids and we all tangled up in the cares of this world, like the world, then we didn't conform to the world instead of being transformed by God. And we are transformed by renewing our mind, renewing our thoughts, renewing what's going on within us. And then that gives us the strength and the power to go on and be a light for the world and then be effective witnesses for Christ. He's not supposed to do it on his own. He does it through us for everyone else. Okay? Y'all get that? Okay? So we have to learn to be helpers one to the other. Remember that point too. Helpers one to the other. Not in lust, but in love. Okay? It's a difference. When you lusting in it, it's a personal thing. It's a personal fulfillment. It's a personal pleasure. It stops with self. Okay? But when it's a pure love, a godly love, it flows beyond you. Onto the generations to come, because you don't know whose child you may touch or whose life you may touch, and it touch a generation and the next generation and the next generation. Just like this song I was talking about, Genesis, that the choir sung, that was Vincent. He's dead and gone, but now I done spoke it, and now I done spoke another to another generation, and they might use it to another generation. And I mean, it's just meant for it to keep going and keep growing. And I mean, if we just let Christ out of our lives, leave him out of our lives, and not share and not be fruitful and prosper, then there's nothing left. There's nothing left. We have officially conformed to the world, and the world is not going anywhere. It's not going to grow. It's not going to prosper. But we, as children of God, are meant to prosper. We're meant to be fruitful. We're meant to grow. not stay in the same place. We can't remain where we are and expect to go where we're supposed to go. We have to change our minds. And the only way to do that is to ask the Lord to create in you a clean heart and renew the right spirit within you. Get rid of all that stuff. Get rid of it. Press past it. I don't care how much it tries to come and be a present situation in your life. Press beyond it.
I worship and adore you. Just want to tell you, Lord, I love you more than anything. Oh, 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 I love you.
Coming down your face.